Ladies and gentlemen of YouTube, hello, my name is Unholiness and welcome to a brand new video. Today we are going to talk about Star Wars The Old Republic, not mistaken by Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. So here I am with the top 5 reasons what makes SWTOR unique. Before starting our countdown, make sure you hit that subscribe button with the bell and lean back in your chair, and now, enjoy! Reason number 5. Roleplay. Have you ever grabbed anything and pretended that it was a lightsaber? Well, you don't have to pretend anymore. You can be the Jedi or Sith your heart desire. The game arms you with huge range of emotes and toys that you can utilize to enhance your roleplay experience. But you can't roleplay anywhere because random players disrupt you, I hear you cry. Fear not, Star Wars The Old Republic has player housing called strongholds and even big starship for guilds to customize your needs. Reason number 4. Immersion. The game has the best leveling experience I've ever seen in any MMORPG. Almost every quest that you find is voice acted and is dependent on the choice you make, which makes it hugely replayable and unique each time you do it. SWTOR is a Star Wars movie where you are the main character.
And you, soldier, when you're done playing honor guard, get back to your post. This isn't a luxury yacht.
Yes, sir.
Reason number 3. Diverse worlds. You can explore famous worlds from the movies or from your favorite books. From the noble houses of Alderaan, through the icy plains of Hoth to the depths of Manan, you can find all kinds of planets and you can explore them all you want. Reason number 2. You are your character. With each choice you make, your character becomes more unique. And you don't have to follow any rules. You can be a merciful Sith who goes head-on against the Empire, or you can be the fallen Jedi who wouldn't show mercy to his own family. Commit to either to the dark side or to the light side, all that is matters is your choice. Your character has a personality, just like you have.
All Marines have been neutralized, scanning for additional threats.
What's going on? Sir, stay calm, Ensign. Everyone stay calm.
No threats found. The bridge is now secure.
Cooperate or die.
Hands off the consoles. We're all listening, my lord.
I can handle this, Lieutenant. I'm Captain Revenant Orzik. I'm pretty sure I know what this is about. For the record, I take complete responsibility for my actions.
Captain Orzik, I'm told you disobeyed a direct order from Grand Moff Kilran.
Yes, I had no idea he'd respond this brutally. He must want the Brentel Star's passenger pretty badly. Maybe he just hates me. The Black Talon would be destroyed chasing a battleship. I've fought in the war before and I'll fight again, but I don't do suicide missions.
Suicide was deciding you could ignore your superiors.
The captain's dead! The captain's dead!
Reason number 1. Companions and relationship with NPCs. This would be under the immersion, but it's so fundamental it needs its own spot and nowhere else but on the top. You have companions as you play through the game, and each of them will have a personality. Your decisions can affect them directly or even destroy them. They will approve or disapprove your decision or even fall in love with you. They can fall for you to the point where you can marry one of them. But be careful. You can make a decision that will kill your loved one too. This is serious, by the way. You can be immersed to the game to a point that is too much to admit publicly. That's how good it is. And we peaked. We are at the top of the list, everyone. I would just say one more thing. This was not a review, the game is not perfect, but I would say if you're looking forward at least one of these points, the game will be worth playing for you too. Do you agree with the points I made? Or did I leave you desire to know more? If that's the case, get up from your chair and comment down below. Either you support my points and agree completely, or you would make a different list entirely. I thank you for watching.